この番組はご覧のスポンサーの提供でお送り。
Difference between you started a journey about 1971 and 1969?
Oh yeah, it's a big difference.
Big difference.
Because we weren't that big when we started. It took us about 6 years to attain some good success. And it's just starting now. I don't think the end is close.
Yeah. What you love. Joined the band, they were very musically oriented, more fusion rock, and then at that point in time, with me coming to the band, we decided, all of us, we were going to become more song-oriented, more vocals and things like that. So that was the beginning, and since then it's progressed, as years have gone by, to where it is right now, so it's very different from when it started, in the style of music and the approach and everything.
Why? Because it's the best way for me to be the most creative and be my own boss at the same time. Yeah, I decided when I was about 13 that I didn't want a regular job because I had a regular job and I didn't like people bossing me around telling me what to do, so I thought that I had to be in a profession where I could be my own boss.
Okay, I'm a guitar technician for Journey, which includes all the guitar repair, restringing, tuning for Neil Sean, Jonathan Cain, and Ross Mallory. Band crew, of course, were the last to set up every morning. And I assist our electronics technician and the rest of the band crew in setting up all the band gear, electronics, and of course, all my guitars and all the string changing and repair that needs to be done. And normally my busy day starts after sound checks when I have to start changing all the strings and retuning. So we use about 7 to 8 guitars per show and 2 basses. So, and those are restrung daily.
It gets real long because as soon as I finish tours, I usually do records, so I'm not always home. And we've been home now for about 3 months, so it's real nice. So you always get homesick when you're gone for a long time.
Right now, the weather in San Francisco is pretty wet. It's been raining for the last 2 months because in San Francisco, it very rarely snows, almost never. So actually, there's some very beautiful things about the rain and the fog, but there's a lot of floods there also. So we have a combination of beauty and the ugliness of nature too. I say the most beautiful parts of the city are in the waterfront in downtown area, and there's a lot of nice museums and shopping areas to go to. And outside of the city, when you go north of San Francisco over the Golden Gate Bridge, is Marin County, which is very beautiful. And all nice countryside with beautiful homes. And even north of that is Napa Valley, where they have wine country, which is also a great place to visit. That's about it.
We had an album out called Infinity. Yeah. We had a song on that album that was about our hometown. You know which one I'm talking about. Well, my friends, I'm lonely too.
So many memorable things. I think mostly just all the people we've met over the years, and there's just so many different people that we've met. I think that's really the most memorable thing is just all the people.
Sure, I'm homesick right now, but I'm enjoying myself at the same time. Our tours are long. However, we've always had the opportunity with the privileges we have to bring the ladies along if they wish. And in this case, for the Frontiers Tour, there's a long time period that we'll be touring, but there's breaks every 2-3 weeks. There's a few days to go home, so there's another alternative.
We hadn't seen each other for 2 weeks, and that's a pretty long time. You know, 2.5-3 weeks is getting, you know, pretty long, and we were going through some, I don't know, she just seemed to be drifting from me, you know, farther away, and I seemed to be drifting, and the line, you know, it's just that line on the, it's love long distance, you know, and she was off doing her thing, and you know, well, you didn't call me last night, you didn't call me, you said you were going to call me, I couldn't call you, I was on the road, I was in the plane, or I was here or there, you know.
Sure.
So finally, when she did come to the hotel room, I just, you know, took out this little keyboard and said, I've got a surprise for you, sit down here. And she sat on the bed and I played it for her, and she just broke down in tears.
Faithfully.
Well, listen, we live in a fantasy world, you know, and we go through heavy emotions out there. I mean, it's very difficult even to hold a personal relationship with somebody that you might even love a lot at home, because you're so removed from everything, and that's a different world out there, and people don't understand that. But I'm willing to sacrifice it just to play. I like to play live.
Yeah.
You know, and I like to play for the people. There's no other bigger high for me than to walk out of a concert hall when you look at the audience and they are just feeling so good and they're feeling no pain, because they came there to be relieved too. Mm-hmm. So in turn, I'm doing it to myself and the audience at the same time, and it just feels so good.
Yeah.
just decided that musically we were going to try and take on new musical frontiers. And we felt that in the age of technology that we live in, with the rise of the computer and so much electronic things that are affecting our lives that we have to learn to adjust to, that is a frontier as well. So we are on the border of a changing frontier constantly that we must adjust to, and we felt that it was a good way to describe the way we were feeling.